Hey, what's up, guys? It's Luke, and you're watching Luke the Gathering. Thanks for being here. I really appreciate it. We did Midnight Hunt last time, and we did AFR the time before that. We are going to be now drafting a pack of Innistrad Crimson Vow, and I gotta say, I've not done well with this set in draft. It's a really tricky set to draft, and putting a deck together is not the easiest thing, in my opinion. So let's open up this pack, and just like always, I'm going to pick this pack. What are we going to pick out of this pack and put them in order of what I would have done? And then, of course, you can tell me how you would have drafted the pack. I'm always interested in your thoughts. We got a Dreadlight Monstrosity, Parish Blade Trainee, Lightning Wolf, Wanderlight Spirit, Vampire's Kiss, Sporeback Wolf, Mind Leech Ghoul, Blood Crazed Socialite, Wedding Invitation, Ragged Recluse, Cloaked Cadet, Groom's Finery, Hero's Downfall, Mirror Hall Mimic, Plains Wolf, and the other token. So let's get rid of the land. Are rare, and this is definitely when they always say, is it a Prince or a Pauper set? Pauper being, you know, the commons are really good. A Prince set is where the rares are better, and this is definitely a Prince set. Let's see what we have here. We have the Mirror Hall Mimic. This is a creature spirit. It says, you may have Mirror Hall Mimic enter the battlefield as a copy of any creature on the battlefield, except it's the spirit in addition to its other types. So that's really pretty good. I mean, you can copy the best creature on the field, and could be your creature, so you can have two awesome creatures, or you can copy one of their creatures and effectively take their best creatures. So that's really sweet, and it can disturb into Ghastly Mimicry. It's enchantment aura, enchant creature. At the beginning of your upkeep, create a token that's a copy of enchanted creature, except it's a spirit in addition to its other types. So you put this on there, and you get a copy during the upkeep of the creature that it's on, and then it's every upkeep. That spirit doesn't go away either. So let's say we have the Dreadlight Monstrosity. You know, you put the aura on it. At the beginning of upkeep, you get another one of these, and then the next turn you get another one of these, and the next turn you get another one of these. That's pretty amazing. I think we're going to take the Mirror Hall Mimic first. I think that is a no-brainer. Really great. The next card that I saw as I was going through the pack was Hero's Downfall. It just costs two black and a white, two black and a colorless. Simply says, destroy target creature or planeswalker. Really good removal. Removal is so important in any limited format, but man, that's just going to be a really good card. So let's go ahead and take Hero's Downfall next. Okay, now this is where it gets a little bit more difficult. We have a bunch of stuff that can transform, like this one. It's a two drop. We have this bigger vampire. Vampires are kind of a key type in this set. I think I would go with the Blood-Crazed Socialite next. What does this do? It's a creature vampire. It has menace, so it can't be blocked unless you block it with two or more. It's a 3-3. And it says, when Blood-Crazed Socialite enters the battlefield, create a blood token. Blood tokens are really important in this format. They are tremendous value. And so you get a blood token when it comes in. And whenever Blood-Crazed Socialite attacks, you can sacrifice a blood token and it gets +2/+2. So it's a 5/5. And it gives you that blood token when it comes in. And if somehow you can flicker this, I don't know if there's any flickering effects in this format, but that's cool. Or Blood-Crazed Socialite, you can create another one with Mirror Hall Mimic. You'd have 2 3/3s, trigger another blood token. That might be a neat little trick to do. That's what I'm taking next. Okay. Next, I think we'll go with the Ragged Recluse. It's a two drop. one in a black. Human peasant, at the beginning of your end step, if you discarded a card this turn, transform Ragged Recluse. So 2-1, not that great, but I feel like you can discard cards pretty easily if you really try to draft cards that can discard cards. It turns into Odious Witch. It says, whenever Odious Witch attacks, if any player loses a life, and you gain a life. It's 3-3. So pretty decent body. I would take that. Next. Let's take a look at the rest of this pack. The Cadet. 2-4 Cadet. Hey, that's pretty good stats. Let's see what it has. It has training. So if it attacks with another creature that has greater power, it gets a +1/+1 counter. Whenever one or more +1/+1 counters are put onto one or more humans, you control draw a card. So 2-4, I like the stats. 4 and a green is kind of expensive, but he does have training. It is a human. This would be good in like a human deck with green and white. I think I'll take the Cloaked Cadet. That seems like a decent card to pick up. The rest of these, I don't know. Let's take this next. I think I like cards like this. I don't know if anyone else does. Vampire's Kiss. 1 and a black. Sorcery. Target player loses 2 life. You gain 2 life. And then you get 2 blood tokens. I think in decks where you're really trying to get more and more blood tokens, this is just a nice thing that happens to you. You get 2 life, they lose 2 life, and you get 2 blood tokens. Simple. Doesn't really affect the board too much, but I like it. I'm going to take that next. This is kind of a big creature. It's 4 and 2 blue. It's a Crab Whore. Has Ward 2. And then for 3 and 2 blue, Dreadlight Monstrosity can't be blocked this turn. Activate only if you own a card in exile. Which, if you're in blue, turns out you're in blue or blue-white, having a card in exile isn't too hard, especially for 5 mana. At that point, you know, in the game, or whenever this card enters the game, really, you probably would have cards in exile. This might be a good finisher in limited. So I think I'm going to go with the Dreadlight Monstrosity. And then what are we going to do? We have these cards left. I think I'll take the Lightning Wolf. 3 and a red. And then Lightning Wolf gains first strike until end of turn. So you can have it have first strike. 4-3 with first strike is actually pretty significant. Can defeat a lot of things with first strike. 4-3. 4-3 is a pretty good stat line. I'm taking Lightning Wolf. And then I like flyers. Let's go with the Wander Light Spirit. It's a 2 and a blue for flying creature spirit. Wander Light Spirit can only block creatures with flying, so that's unfortunate. It's a 2-3. Great to block things on the ground, but there are plenty of flyers who, you know, would be able to block with a 3 toughness, so that's pretty good. I'll take the flyer. And then let's see. You know what? Let's see the Wedding Invitation. It says, when an invitation enters the battlefield, draw a card. So for 2, you get to draw a card right away. And then you can sacrifice the invitation. You can make a creature not be able to block. Or it can't be blocked. So a creature that you got cannot be blocked. It goes through. And if it's a vampire, it gains lifelink. I think that's okay. I think I've picked it up quite often, but I rarely ever use that actual card. The rest of the cards I don't think really matter so much. I guess the Mind Leech Ghoul. This card has exploit. It can exploit a creature, and then, you know, an opponent exiles a card from their hand. The only thing I don't like about exploit here is that none of the creatures, you don't have a lot of decay tokens like you had in the other set, Midnight Hunt. So, you know, you never really felt that bad about getting rid of those decay tokens. In these cases with exploit, you're actually getting rid of some solid bodies on the field, which doesn't feel nearly as nice. I think we'll go with the Parish Blade Trainee next. It's Human Soldier. When this dies, you get to put its counters on a target creature that you control. So it has training, so it only has 1 power, so hopefully it'll be able to get, you know, a counter or 2 onto it, and then, you know, pass those off when it dies. I feel like it's a bit clunky to get that to happen, though. Sporeback Wolf, just a 2-2 for 2. If it's your turn, it's a 2-4, so it's a little bit tougher. 2-4, I guess it's decent. Nothing I'm going to be jumping out of my chair about with the Sporeback Wolf, but it's okay. And then Groom's Finery. You know, dropped it. Dropped it again. Oh my gosh. I'm like butterfingers today. It's an equipment where it says equipped creature gets +2/+0. It has an additional O +0/+2 and has death touch as long as an equipment named Bride's Gown is attached to a creature you control. So you need to have this and the gown to kind of make it decent. And then it costs 2 to equip. I just don't think it's a really good deal. I don't know why anyone would take this. Yeah, it just seems way off there. I mean, it definitely fits the theme with the Crimson Vow, the wedding theme. But other than that, it's just not something I would really ever take. So let's go through the pack. First pick was Mirror Hall Mimic, then Hero's Downfall, Blood Crazed Socialite, Ragged Recluse, Cloaked Cadet, Vampire Kiss, Dreadlight Monstrosity, Lightning Wolf, Wanderlight Spirit, Wedding Invitation, Mind Leech Ghoul, Parish Blade Trainee, Sporeback Wolf, and then the Groom's Finery is our last one. Let me know what you would have done. Was your picks the same as mine, or would you have drafted something else, or did I miss something that's just totally awesome, didn't do anything with it? Love to know your opinion. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.